Hello, welcome back. So in this part, we will study what is the role of structural engineer and architect and why architect has to learn structural engineering. Basically, structural engineer is the professional who designed the structure, and structural engineers are actually the civil engineer. Well, structural engineering is basically a specialization in which a structural engineer is qualified, and these two members, structural engineers and architect, they actually built a structure or a building. So we will take an example, and with that example, we will try to understand what is the role of structural engineer and what is the role of architect. So here I'm taking an example of Lotus Temple, its construction. So we will see from the start how it is being formulated and how it is being constructed, and we see how how it looks like. So first of all, we will see the first application, which is related to the architecture. Well, first of all, there is a requirement from the client that we have to make a building, an iconic building, and in that case the client will contact with the architect. Now architect will try to develop an idea. Now those idea can be helped from the nature also, as I discussed earlier also. So with the nature, now if we look at this particular example, so again this example is inferred from the nature. Now this is actually a shape of lotus flower. So with the lotus flower, architect has an idea, like he wants to build a building which looks like a lotus flower. So to develop the concept, he will try to make the models, he will try to finalize the forms of building, and he will try to design the space, how much space it will occupy and how much space a particular element will take. So all these things architect will do, and also at the same time, after finalizing the shape, after finalizing the form, he will make some architecture drawing. So after that, what will happen? Architect will form a team. Now that team will be comprising many professionals, like the electricians, because in a building electricians is required for electrical fitting. Similarly for sanitary fitting is again a requirement which is being provided in the building. So sanitary fitting will be done by another professional, which is plumber. But in the team of architect, there is a very important professional who is a structural engineer. So structural engineer will be responsible for designing, for analyzing the form of building that architect has proposed. So the second stage would be the analysis. Well, architect will go to the structural engineer and he will present his proposal along with the drawings, along with the design concepts to the structural engineer. Structural engineer then will try to analyze the elements, the building that that architect has proposed, and he will try to analyze it. He will in the analysis he will try to find out what force or what effect is coming on the building, and those effect will be in terms of the load. So what load is coming on the building, that that will have to be calculated by the structure engineer, and that comes under the domain of analysis. So analysis is all about determining the forces in each and every element. So you can see as this building is Lotus Temple, so Lotus Temple is comprising various leaves. So in the analysis, he will have various leaves, he will analyze it, and he will try to find out how much force these particular leaves will experience. So those force will be determined, and along with the force, there may be some other effect of force which will also need to be considered. So all those effect will also be determined in the analysis domain. So once structural engineer is finalized, he determined the forces in the element, in the building, then what will happen? Then he will try to design it. Now designing means proportioning the element. Well, to resist a particular force, how much size of element will be required? For example, these are the leaves. So they, if they are experiencing, say, P force, so to resist the P force, what should be the shape of this leaf and what should be the size of the leaf? For example, the thickness of leaf. So all those things will be designed. All those things will be proportioned in the domain of design. So once structure engineer is finished with designing all the elements, sizing, after that, the next stage is the detailing. Now, detailing means the all the design that structure engineer has carried out. Now, those design will have to be shown in the form of drawing. So all the drawings will be made of the building, and then those drawing will be sent to the site where the actual building is being constructed. Now on the site, there will be some other professionals such as site engineer, site supervisor, civil engineer, which will be actually executing the construction work, and they actually require a drawing. So they will execute this work on the basis of the drawing that is being prepared by structure engineer. Now, after execution, we see the final product. So that is the process of construction or constructing any building. So now you see, architect is mainly the leader who is proposing a type of building. And after that, architect is supposed to make a team of different professionals which will be required to make the building. Now in that, there is a very important professional who is a structural engineer. Now, structural engineer mainly speaks the language of science and mathematics. So to understand his language, architect needs to learn his language, and which is actually the structural engineering. Now, in this analysis part and design part, so if there is any complication, if there is any communication, so for proper communication, architect, as I said, architect needs to learn the language of structural engineer, and which is actually the structural engineering. So all the topic that we will learn in this subject, it is because we try to learn the language of the structural engineer. So architect is not responsible for designing any building, but he learned this language so that he can communicate properly with the structure engineer. So that is the thing that we need to look at. So I hope now the thing is clear. Why do we need to study this subject? Why do we need to study this structural engineering? So now in this course, we will try to understand what is analysis and design. As I discussed in the previous slide also, analysis is all about finding or determining the forces that cause the deformation to the structure, and designing is all about proportioning the elements so that they can take the required load. So we know the application of load to a structure, it causes the structure to deform. So load will try to deform the structure, and ultimately it will induce various types of force in different elements of the structure. And therefore calculating the magnitude of these forces and the deformation that caused them is referred to as structural analysis. And after that, we try to design it. So structural design includes the arrangement and proportioning of structures and their parts, so they will satisfactorily support the load to which they may be subjected. So in this course, we will be under this domain. We will try to understand the force. We will understand how force effect is being calculated. What are the various laws of forces, and how do we find out the resultant of forces, and what are the various application of the forces? So that is all about that we are going to learn in this course. So that is the lecture. So I have taken references of this lecture from these books. Thank you.